Hey guys, subscribe and unsubscribe. People that love us, people that hate us, welcome to Love Distance. You know, I'm Daryl, and you have the wonderful and beautiful Shantae.
Hi guys.
And today we have a story time video. And wait a minute. Wait, what's the video about today again?
I forgot to.
Really?
No. I'm sorry. It's about how our friends felt about us being in a long distance relationship.
Yes. So, you know, we're going to do, you know, I'm going to be a gentleman, you know, I'll let Shantae go first.
Can you let me go first?
She's going to take it away.
So, first, if you want to be in a long-distance relationship and your friends tell us no and tell us this and that about the person, you have to look in within yourself and decide if it's going to be worth it, because you and other person are going to be in a relationship. You and your friend then, not in a relationship. Okay? So that's the first thing. Second thing, your life, so you have to live it how you want to live it. Because some people are going to tell you, him not cheating, you know she not have another guy down there with her, so on. So you have to decide if it's worth it, if you and the person believe someone can do it, and do it. Alright? But for us, our friends were supportive of the relationship. So we never really have no struggle there. So but for me, how my friends, first of all, my friends didn't even know I was talking to anyone. My friends didn't even know I was talking to anyone because I don't know, for some reason I just felt like I didn't want everybody's opinion in my head. So I was just like, alright, let me just do it for myself and see how it goes. Because I don't want to get into it and then left, and I never want all of that. So after we got together is when I told my friends, and they were very surprised. They were very surprised. Yeah. One of my friends though, she was upset with me because she knew of Daryl, but she didn't know that we were talking like that. So yeah, she was upset with me. But anyway, she's over it now, you know. She's over it now. But other than that, everybody was supportive of it. They were very happy for me. And they got to meet him last year when he came. And yeah, they've all gotten along with him so far. So yeah. How about you, babe?
For me, I've been called names. I've been called crazy. Wild. Nonsense. Yeah, idiot. Yeah, fool. I've been called many names. Even the ones that were supporting me were still calling me names. It was really something. But for the people that were close, were like super close to me, you know, like what, who was in my last video, Joe. Mm-hmm. Nah, he was more excited about the relationship than I was. I guess because he was really putting my happiness forward. Cause he knew like my last relationship was really a hassle, and you know, but he was very happy to see that I was with someone that really made me happy, and I didn't have to run to him every 2 seconds and be like, you know what, say, should do this again.
Yeah.
But
sorry to interject. He met me before we got together.
Oh yeah, that too. Yeah, he was the one that drove me to the airport to meet Shantae for the first time, and he was very excited. He was very happy. He hanged out, and you know, we hanged out that day, and he was like, yo, Daryl, I think you made a good choice. Matt not even made a good choice. He was the one that was influencing me to actually say yes to being a boyfriend. He was one of the ones that would be like, yo, Daryl, you know, if you want DJ, you can do it. Because, like, you know, she's nice enough, you know, she makes you happy, like, why not? And I was like, you know, say you're right. So why not? Is it what really I would move up? So that's him, and then everybody else that was, like, close in that circle. And when I was living back with a couple of my friends, they're all mostly supportive. The only people that really that didn't really went forward when it comes on the family, you know, there was always different sides to it. You know, people that supported me, people that didn't. And then when it comes on to people outside of that, like my coworkers, they're the ones that thought I was like crazy. It's like, cause at work they call me Mr. M. Like, Mr. M, your girlfriend's weird. Weird? What? You know what? How does that even work? How you guys communicate? How you guys talk? How does that happen? And then I'm just like calmly like, yeah. Like, how often do you see her? I'm like, once a year. Like, they're like, Mr. M, you sure you're okay? She forcing you to do this? Like, it was honestly, I lucky didn't feel that like much like malice towards them or whatever.
Mm-hmm. They just didn't understand.
Yes, so. Yes. I was sure of what I wanted, and I was okay with it. There was the only thing they probably would have done, like constantly hearing negativity about this, is slowly put doubts in you. But you know, once you know, when you communicate those doubts with your partner,
mm-hmm.
I definitely communicated with Chante about everything, you know, and then we talked about it, and we have doubts together, right? And then we just like, okay, address these doubts. Are there something that like legit crush us, or is something that can we use to build us up?
Mm-hmm.
And you know, it's been 2 years and we're still together. It means that, you know, all those doubts have been crushed. Now we're still strong. No matter what people say, we're still together.
Yep.
We're still gonna make this work. We're gonna push forward. You know, we got a goal to meet. We're gonna meet it.
The both of it's all about the two of you. How can the two of you strive in this relationship? Because if one person in it and the other one in it, then it's not gonna work out. So you both have to be invested. Sorry, babe, for cutting you. You both have to be invested, you both have to want it, you both have to know that there are going to be struggles, so you have to try to overcome it together, and talk about how you feel, how it, you know, you have to talk about how you feel. You can't just sit down and say, boy, I'm kind of tired of this, and I'm going to know. You have to talk about it, with each other. So we can find some solution to the problem. Because if you don't talk about it, they're going to build up, you know, end up in an argument, and then relationship dissolve. Yeah,
as Shantae says, is if you do feel something, you're in a long-distance relationship, and you do feel like something's not right, something is wrong, the best thing you can do is talk to your partner. Don't run to nobody else.
Mm-hmm.
That makes no sense. Talk to your partner. Your partner will say, yo, listen, I'm feeling this type of way. Like, can we fix this? Is this fixable?
Mm-hmm.
Right? Is this sometimes maybe a misunderstanding? Right? There's times me and Shantae talk, I'm gonna say something or she says something, but we look at it outside of a different context, and then like, no, she upset with me for no reason.
Mm-hmm.
But isn't it when I sense it and be like, yo, babe, are you okay? Right?
That's,
you know, there's times that you don't feel like talking. There's times you don't feel like talking, but like once you communicate, or like if you're really upset or whatever, just take your time once you communicate,
mm-hmm.
and try to figure out something. As I said, when that happens and we actually talk about it, then I explain to her like, this is what I meant, I didn't mean that. Then everything works out, and then she's like, okay, babe, I'm sorry, and then we just move on. And then sometimes it's vice versa, where when she says something and then I misinterpret it.
Mm-hmm.
Because like when you're over phones and sometimes the phone disconnects,
especially if you're texting, you don't get an emotion through a text. Somebody can text something and in a your edit sound upset, but in a film it is a joke. So that also.
Yeah, it's just the phone disconnects, and then like I get very, very frustrated when I'm trying to talk to Shantae and the call is just not working. It's
so upset.
I lose my mind. I'm like, babe, you know, I can't talk to you for the day, but can I do it? Because I thought I'm going to flick it through the window. But yeah, that's it sometimes. That's even some of my struggles when trying to communicate over a device. You'd think 2020 would have better internet everywhere. You'd think. You see what I say? I gave her a video call and the person looked like you watch Rice Grade. Like, bro. But the person and they see it, them are jiggy, like.
And if it's not that, like, gone, and in another video, we'll tell you about the struggles that we face.
Yeah, definitely.
Being in a long distance relationship.
Because probably talking about the phone itself, we could have a whole video session.
The phone itself.
You know, I want to say an encouragement to all people in this relationship. Literally, most you have to do is just communicate with each other. Let each other know how it's feeling. If you're feeling doubts, feeling struggles, let each other know. There's no sense for you to be in a long-distance relationship for years going on to months when you know that you guys are not happy. It makes no sense. It's just going to make the relationship very difficult, very hard. If you really feel like it's not working out, just communicate with your partner. Maybe your partner has the right thing to say to make you feel better about the whole situation, or the person could say something that makes you feel worse.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like, if you guys have to break up, you guys have to break up. Like,
if it's not working, it doesn't make sense to push something that's not working. It doesn't hurt you and the other person. So if it's not working, just end it. But if you can't overcome it, talk about it, try to make a plan to overcome it.
So thank you guys for watching. Subscribe for more.
Share, tell a friend, subscribe.
Yeah, comment, leave a comment.
Ask us
some questions.
We read all comments.
Maybe next video we answer these questions.
Think
about us. Love us. So we love you. We appreciate you.
Yes, like. Don't forget to click the notification bell.
Pop, pop, pop. All right, later, guys. We love
you.
Bye,
guys.
Until next time.
We out.